yeah, we just had a really nice hike and fly down with a new EIKO 2. Very nice.
Welcome to the Flybubble Paragliding channel.
We are free flight experts and equipment specialists helping you get the best flying experience.
Hello! So we've just been up for a quick little hike and fly with the guys from Supair. They took us up. Julien and Hugo took us up and we went up. And had a really nice hike and fly, which is great. Trying out the new EIKO 2 and the Radical 4. So it's our first flights in those. And Nancy, how was your landing?
Well, second time landing on snow, and it's a little icy this evening, so I didn't land on my feet, or stay on my feet is probably more to the point, but so I had a nice little glide.
Yes,
bottom glide.
Yeah. I was going to film Nancy's landing, but I kind of just pointed the camera in the other direction. I felt that was best, really.
That was probably best, yeah. But wow, what a lovely flight, and very nice harness, just very nice and simple and comfortable, and enjoyed flying with that. And the wing,
very difficult to launch, aren't they?
Oh my goodness,
really tricky to launch. Yeah, very difficult. Yeah, I think there's actually an auto launch button.
Yes,
it's one of those where
it just popped up.
Yeah,
just had to control it and off we were.
Yeah, the wind on the slope we were on was a little off to the side. It was quite an easy wind, but a bit variable from the side, but the gliders just inflated and came up so nicely. It was really effortless to launch.
Yeah, very nice.
So Nancy's forward launches are pretty good. I need to work to get as good as her. I need to practice a bit on those. But that came up really nicely.
Yes.
And nice glide out. We're going to aim to do a full review of the EIKO 2, hopefully, if time allows it. So I've got the new Supair Radical 4, and I'm going to give it the intuitivity test. Intuitivity test. How easy is it to do? So I'm going to have my first go at reversing it. No instructions. So zip. And the last bit, give a look. So the way this works, it looks like depending on the volume, you can do that. What you've got on the front here, I've got an extra pocket for you to put some stuff in there. And also, you need to look closely for that. I've got these bits of mesh on either side, so that's, and I actually use that. It's a great place to stuff your jacket or your extra bits of clothing that you're, as you walk up and you're, as you're walking up the hill and getting hot and sweaty. So you just put your extra stuff in there, stuff it away. So yeah, first impressions, seems like it's a very clever design, but takes a little bit of getting used to because it's different from other things. So you need to get your head around how it reverses and how it goes in and where the different bits are. But very nice. The rucksack was really comfortable to carry, wasn't it?
Show the very nice, comfortable straps.
And they've put these sort of,
they're shaped.
Yeah, they're shaped and quite padded and quite wide straps, wider than others. So I found it really comfortable to walk with. Obviously it hasn't got a glider in it at the moment, so it probably won't sit in the right shape. It won't work now, but when I had the glider in it, I found that when I did this, and some bags really wobble about on your back and unbalance you, this stayed nicely on my back. It's not a sort of ex-alps racing rucksack, but it's very comfortable to carry, great for what it's designed for hike and fly. So this is just a little sneak peek. I hope you've enjoyed a sneak peek of the EIKO 2 and the Radical 4. Yes indeed, and see you for now.
Bye.
Woohoo!